We're looking up the Fed funds rate. Use the previous workday, if not a workday. Great question from Vicky today. She has a list of dates. I'm looking for a formula to calculate the previous workday only if the date in the list is a weekend or a holiday. She's trying to accrue the Fed fund interest daily, and those rates are only published on business days, so she has to go back a day. All right, so the first question here is all these dates, is it a weekend or a holiday? All right, but before we can do that, we have to take this extra step somewhere in this workbook, add a named range with the federal holidays. So I just have a worksheet here called holidays. These are the federal holidays, plus I added Groundhog's Day in just so it would fall in the range of my dates. And check this out at the bottom, a date way in the future with a note here to insert new rows above this row. So to create a named range, you're gonna select all of these holidays and choose something to call it. You could call it holidays. I'm gonna call it holiday range. You have to click here in the name box that's to the left of the formula bar. Now, no spaces in this, so holiday range like that, so no spaces. I still haven't created the name yet. I have to press enter in order to create that name. The test to make sure that you did that correctly, just click out here and then open the name box and choose holiday range and make sure that it selected your range. Question, is this day a weekend or a holiday? We're gonna use a great function called network days. The thing that's awesome about network days is it includes the first day as a day. Like normally, if you would just do end date minus start date, you're not gonna count both the end date and the start date, but here you do. So we're starting from A2 and we're going to A2, isn't that crazy? And then here for the holiday argument, we're gonna specify that range we just created called holiday range. And what will happen there is if it's a regular day, not a holiday, not a weekend, you're gonna get a 1. But anytime that's a Saturday or a Sunday, you're gonna get a 0 there. And then if it's a holiday, remember my joke about including Groundhog's Day, so that shows up as a 0. So now we have an easy way to detect if any given day is a work day or not. Here's that formula. We're gonna say equal if, open parentheses, network days is equal to 1, then comma, we want A2, otherwise, so another comma. All right, now here's the hard part. We have to go back, not just one day, like here on Sunday, we have to go back 2 days to Friday. And if it was a holiday Monday, we'd have to go back 3 days to the previous Friday. So that's gonna be a function called workday, the workday function. And we start from A2, and then the number of days to go, most people don't know this, this can be negative, so we wanna go back to the previous workday, -1 workdays, and oh, by the way, include the same range of holiday range, like that. So we close the workday function. We're not done though, because that last parenthesis is red. That means that somewhere we're on balance. Remember, we started here with an if function, and that parenthesis is black. So we need one more parenthesis there in order for it to be balanced. You see that the last parenthesis is black. Now I'm gonna press Control Enter here to enter that and all of the values. Here's the gotcha. Workday and NETWORKDAY, those functions are from the analysis tool pack. Became part of Excel as part of Excel 2007, and for whatever reason, those are not programmed to automatically convert to dates. So you get these weird serial numbers. Choose that range, come up here on the Home tab, and change to either a short date or a long date. It doesn't matter which one you want. And let's just do a test here. So like here, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, all backdate to the rate from Friday. My fake holiday here, Groundhog's Day, it backdates to Wednesday. These Saturdays and Sundays, backdate back to Friday. So it is working, right? There's the formula you wanna use. But before you can do that, you have to create the holiday range with the named range. And you have to be prepared that once you enter this formula, you're gonna get serial numbers instead of dates, and you're gonna have to reformat those as dates. Once all that's done though, it's gonna be working and working great. Well, thanks to Vicky for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another NETcast from Mr. Excel.